हेलो, वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग। माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर संजय छाबड़ा, प्रोफेसर फैकल्टी ऑफ लॉ एंड गवर्नेंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमन यूनिवर्सिटी। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज माय सेशन ऑन प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ बैंकिंग फॉर बीबीए एलएलबी फोर्थ सेमेस्टर, एंड दिस इज फर्स्ट सेशन ऑन यूनिट वन अबाउट इंडियन बैंकिंग सिस्टम एंड इवैल्यूएशन ऑफ बैंकिंग इंस्टीट्यूशंस एंड बैंकिंग सिस्टम ऑफ इंडिया। नाउ एज वी नो, बैंक प्लेज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल इन सर्कुलेटिंग कैपिटल बाय क्रिएटिंग क्रेडिट एंड एक्सेप्टिंग डिपॉजिट्स। बैंक इज द चैनल टू डिस्ट्रीब्यूट resources, money from one person to another. Now, how banking evolution of Indian banks in India? Banking in India originated in the last decades of 18th century. The first bank was the General Bank of India, which started in 1786. Bank of Hindustan was the second bank, which started in 1970. Both are now defunct. The oldest bank in existence in India is the State Bank of India, which originated in the Bank of Calcutta in June 1806, which almost immediately became the Bank of Bengal. So now, the period between 1906 and 1911 saw the establishments of banks inspired by the Swadeshi movement. A number of banks established then have survived to the present, such as Bank of India, Corporation Bank, Indian Bank, Bank of Baroda, Canara Bank and Central Bank of India. Students, during the First World War, that is in between 1914 to 1918, through the end of the Second World War, that is 1939 to 1945, and 2 years thereafter until the independence of India, were challenging for Indian banking. From Bank of Hindustan in 1770, the evolution of banking in India can be divided into three different periods age under. Say like phase one, that is early phase of primitive Indian banks to nationalization of banks in 1969. Phase 2, from nationalization of India banks in 1969 up to advent of liberalization and banking reforms in 1991. And phase 3, from Indian banking financial, that is from Indian financial and banking sector reforms 1991 onwards. Now, in post-independence, India observed the emergence of large number of institutions for providing finance to different sectors of the economy. The entire activities of private sector and foreign banks were restricted through branch banking, branch licensing and regulatory norms. Steps which are taken by the Indian government to regulate banking are: Reserve Bank of India was nationalized in January 1, 1949 under the terms of Reserve Bank of India. In 1949, the Banking Regulation Act was enacted, and the Banking Regulation Act also provided that no new bank or branch of an existing bank could be opened without a license from the RBI, and no two banks could have common directors. This is about post-independence. Then in second phase of nationalization, so the nationalization of banks in India took place in 1969 by Mrs. Indira Gandhi. It nationalized 14 banks. Before the steps of nationalization of Indian banks, only State Bank of India, that is SBI, was nationalized. Nationalization of 7 State Banks of India took place on 16th July 1960. The second phase of nationalization of Indian Bank took place in the year 1980, 7 more banks were nationalized with a deposit over 200 crores. The stated reason for the nationalization was to give the government more control of credit delivery. And the banking technology which was adopted was introduction of online banking in India, that is after nationalization, formation of Committee on Mechanization in the Banking Industry in 1984, providing use of standard check forms and encoders, formation of Committee of Computerization in Banks in 1988, which emphasized that settlement operation must be computerized in the clearing houses of RBI. Formation of Committee on Technology Issues Relating to Payment System, Checks Clearing and Securities Statements Settlements in the Banking Industry in 1994 emphasized on electronic fund transfer system with BankNet communications network, ATMs installed in India by various banks as on end March 2005. That is total number of ATMs, by that time it was 17,642. So this is about two phases, that is pre-nationalized and post-nationalized, and how banking system evolved, evolution of banking system in India. So what are the types of banks? There are three types of banks, that is public sector bank, regional rural bank and private sector bank. Now what is public sector bank? Public sector banks are owned and operated by the government, who has a major share in them. Means government holds majority of shares in the public sector bank. The major focus of these public sector banks is to serve the people rather to earn profits. Like some examples of these type of banks, that is public sector banks, are State Bank of India, Punjab National Bank, Bank of Maharashtra, etc. Then second type of bank is regional rural bank. So regional rural banks were brought into operation with the objectives of providing credit to the rural and agricultural regions, and were brought into effect in 1975 by Regional Rural Bank Act. These banks are restricted to operate only in the areas specified by the government of India. These banks are owned by the state government and a sponsor bank. This sponsorship was to be done by a nationalized bank and a state cooperative bank. Prathama Bank is one such example, which is located in Moradabad in UP. Prathama Bank is one of the example of regional rural bank, which is located in Moradabad in UP. Then comes private sector bank. Now what is private sector bank? Private sector banks are owned and operated by private institutions. They are free to operate and are controlled by market forces. A greater share is held by private players and not the government. Examples of private sector banks are, say, like Axis Bank, ICICI Bank, HDFC Bank, Kotak Mahindra Bank, etc. So we came to know about three types of bank. Now what are the performance of these banks? So first we will discuss about performance of public sector bank. So public sector bank, we can say that plays a very important role. As we know that the financial system of any country consists of financial institutions, financial markets, financial instruments, financial services and financial assets. An efficient and a smooth financial system plays an important role in nation's economic development. A well-developed country will have a well-organized financial institutions. Financial institutions are divided in two categories, that is banking and non-banking. Bank plays a very pivotal role in India's economy. The year 1969 was a landmark in the history of commercial banking in India. In July 1969, the government nationalized 14 major banks of the country, and in 1980, 6 more banks were nationalized. So, the first 5-year plan held in the 1951 accorded in the development of the rural areas as the highest priority. So, the plan was for the time period between 1951 to 56. The All India Rural Credit Survey Committee advised the government to create state-partnered and state-owned banks. An act was passed in the Parliament in May 1955 and the State Bank of India was constituted. Later, the State Bank of India Act was passed in 1959 to take over the associate banks of SBI and its subsidiaries. The pre-nationalization bank period saw a lion's share in the industrial sector in the bank's credit. Large-scale industries cornered a large portion of the credit and the share of small industries were marginal. There were many reasons for the dominance of the large-scale industries in the banking sector. Many commercial banks were under the ownership and control of big industrial houses. A disturbing feature of the pre-nationalization policy was the negligence of agriculture sector to the bank's credit. So here, this is about pre-nationalization. And the post-nationalization period witnessed certain drastic change in the economy. All the leading commercial banks of the country were nationalized in the year 1969 with some objective in mind. And the objectives of nationalization were as follows: to break the ownership and control of banks by a few business families. Second objective, to prevent concentration of wealth and economic power. And third objective is to mobilize savings of the masses from every nook and corner of the country. So my dear students, these are about types of bank, like, as I said, public sector bank, regional rural bank and private sector bank. So in this session we have discussed about evolution of banking system in India. Which was the first bank, second bank? Now, as we know that both the first and second bank are now defunct. Now, the very important role played by the banking system in India is by State Bank of India. And today, even in this session, we have discussed about phases, that is pre-nationalization and post-nationalization, that is 1969, then second one from 1991 onwards. Then we have discussed about types of bank, like public sector bank, regional rural bank and private sector bank. For any economy, especially in a democratic country like India, public sector bank plays very, very important role, as majority of the shares are held by the government, and the main aim of public sector bank is not to earn profit but to give service to the people. Public sector bank plays very important role in creation of credit and accepting deposits from the public. Second is regional rural bank. Regional rural bank is operated mainly in rural areas, and these banks, their main function is to promote agriculture by providing loan and credit facilities to the agriculturists, to the farmers, so that they can promote agriculture. And third is private sector bank. Private sector bank, nowadays in modern world, you will find most of the private banks playing very important role, very active role, as like HDFC Bank, ICICI Bank, Axis Bank, Kotak Mahindra Bank, etc. And privatization of bank is done, or private banks are the one which give maximum services to the people. But even then, we must have a government must have some control over this private sector banks, that they should give service. No doubt profit earning is their aim, but at the same time they should go for service motive also. So this is our first session about banking. We'll continue with more sessions. I hope this is clear to you students. About from this part you can read, explain what is banking system in India, how banking system is evolved, or what are the types of bank. Till we meet for the second session, bye.